Treat me, they make me feel so alone, even when they're here. I'm not like anyone else, cause they just wanna hurt me, stop me and torture me, but that's alright, cause I know who I am, but still no one believes.
Presentation is not intended for minors.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this week's Viewer's Choice. This week's Viewer's Choice winner is Space Jam. Thing is, though, RetroArch doesn't recognize Space Jam as an actual playable game, so we're going with the runner-up, unfortunately, so that kind of fucking sucks. So, yeah, we are playing Family Feud instead tonight. I actually really wanted to play Space Jam. No joke, like 20 minutes before the stream started, I downloaded a whole bunch of like Slam Jam remixes for like the intro for the stream, because like when else am I going to like just be able to use a whole bunch of fucking Slam Jam remixes? And yeah, fuck, god damn it. Anyway, without further ado, let's jump straight into this, shall we? Oh, I forgot. I'm not actually tapped into the damn thing. That'll work. Oops. NECA, huh? But no, this is 90s Family Feud, so unfortunately, it's not going to have that kind of shenanigans in it. Sorry, this is 2000s. Family Feud. Is there no music in this, or is it just, yeah?
Hi, welcome to the Family Feud. You can go directly backstage.
Oh, I can create a family straight off the bat. Okay, how does this work?
You can create a new family or edit one that already exists.
I want to create a family. How come I can't go to the empty ones and... Oh, whatever. Well. It's not the cheerleader grandma I was promised. God. I want to edit the family. Should I just do my family and try to recreate. Yeah, try to recreate my family. That'll be funny. Me and my goddamn stupid last name. Last name that everyone spells incorrectly. There we go.
Okay, where's your family from?
Oh, this ain't gonna go anywhere. Know what? Vancouver, because Canada is the closest thing they have to Australia, I'm guessing. Adjective.
Pick a word to describe your family. All included in my game intro.
Is fucked and bogan words. That I can add. Oh, bad. Baffling. Yes, my family is quite baffling.
Give us another word to describe your family. Be creative.
Bland? Mousy works with me. It's Mousy. There's an N in there. Shut up. Everyone always calls me Mousy. I hate it. God, what else we got here? Go with grungy. That works. No, let me, yeah, edit the members. Oh, geez. Up and down changes color, left and right chooses type. Also, what is this music? We might as well start with me, right? There's changing shirt color, but not, you know, race. Oh, here we go, skin. I kind of expected that to be in, you know, body, but apparently not. There we go, that's good enough. Yeah, that's me. That's unfortunately me. Okay, where is bald? God, it's barely changing at all. Okay, we can't change it outside of, like, that. Oh, this sucks. This character creator sucks. Like, I know it's a PS1 game, but fuck. I want to change that mouth. Ew. Come on, give me a goatee. Oh my lord. That's about as close as we're gonna get. Yeah, sure. Me 100% stick of truth. Well, it's actually it's actually surprisingly not that difficult to 100%, so. Alright, so how close can I get to being able to make my dad? That would be funny. He's at least in shape, not like me. that's the closest we're gonna get to old man curly scruffy hair. God, that just looks terrifying. No eyebrows looks terrifying. Oh, all of these options suck. Well, Deimos put in some more points to Sonic 06. Oh, we can't even have full beards. Oh, that sucks. Alright, we'll go with the shitty mustache my dad likes to have sometimes. God. Oh, and both Tecto and Damo have put in some points for Mind Jack. Oh, God. That does not look like my dad in the slightest. Okay, yeah. Just didn't want to change for a bit. That was weird. Very unflattering. I apologize, Mom. I'm sorry, but not much we can really do. Oh, this is really bad. Say about that's close enough. Yeah, that'll do it. Alright, now the hard part. Can I make my brother? That's gonna be the real hard part. Since he dyes his hair red. Like, dude loves the color red so much, he is trying to change his name to Red. Legally. Nope. No, he's actually in shape. Let's say about that, come on. Oh, that's... The orange is probably the closest we're gonna get to, like, a full-on red. God, looks nothing like him. Oh, the 60% of both games. Oh, God. Alright, now I gotta remember what his fucking wife looks like. I've only met her like twice. Now it would be Taka technically, she's South African. I think she had light brown hair? I can't remember. That's probably the best I'm gonna get. That's probably the best I'm gonna get. With this shitty engine. Getting D&D movie vibes from the default painted lips, I won't lie. God. There you go. Save family. Speaking of that D&D movie, I legit... I know nothing about that movie, despite the fact that, you know, I like D&D. Like, I legit know nothing about it. The only thing about that movie I've seen is the promotional burgers they have at Carl's Jr. That's literally the only thing I know about the movie.
Backstage, you need to pick a family.
God, I may be big, but holy crap, at least I'm not that guy. Shit. Loading family.
They're from Vancouver, British Columbia.
I wish.
They describe themselves as baffling, but mostly grungy. Give it up for family number one.
It's the Mounties.
They're from Dallas, Texas. And they describe themselves as...
That's a weird way of...
And athletic.
Crazy athletic, okay. Family number two. That's a very weird delivery on that. Dallas, Texas.
These two families will be playing for big money on the Family Feud. And now, here's the host of Family Feud, Louie Anderson.
Oh, that's Louie Anderson. I've heard the name before, but I've never actually seen the dude.
It's time for the feud.
Oh god, it's FMV! Yeah, let's go. Look how fucking fat the model is, Jesus.
The top five answers are up on the board. Try to guess the most popular answer. Are you ready? Name something you might find in a barn.
Do I have to actually type it in or... Oh god, okay. I'm gonna say chicken.
Let's see if it's up there.
Survey says... Bruh, really?
No, too bad. Family number two, you get a chance.
The FMV skipped.
Family number two.
A tractor, yeah. Cow, you fool!
Let's see if it's up there. Yeah!
Bruh.
Good answer! Good answer! What are you gonna do? Play or pass? Family number two is going to play!
Alright, guess I won't be playing. Sick! Awesome! Let's watch the AI do all the work.
Next player, what's your guess? Name something you might find in a barn.
Corn! Corn.
Right. Let's see if it's on the board.
Yeah. Two people said tractor, two people said corn. Exactly. No one said chicken. Okay.
Next family member, what do you say?
Chicken live in a coop, by the way, not the barn. I don't know. I'm a city person. I don't know. I don't know shit about farms.
Is it there? Show us! Hey, straw.
Excellent.
You got it! Our number one answer!
He looks so fucking awkward.
That's clear. Something you might find in a barn.
That was gonna be my second guess, pitchfork.
All
if
right.
You know, animals weren't in there.
I would have fucked up twice. Cool.
Nice try, but no. Your first strike. Next player, let's go. Name something you might find in a barn.
If Pitchfork isn't in there, I don't think a
Good
rake
answer.
Is going to be
Good
in
answer.
There.
Is it up there?
Oh, well.
Oh, I'm sorry. Strike number two. Family number one, one more strike, and you get a chance to steal. Another player. We need another answer.
Come on, fuck it up. I swear if cow's in there. Oh, hey, speak of the devil.
Let's see if it's up there.
Moo?
All right.
Fucking god.
Absolutely.
Oh, I'm out of ideas because, like, my things were chicken, cow, pitchfork, and, hay, and they've all been done. I said that! I said that. I swear to God, if chickens counts, I'm gonna be so mad. Thank you. Horse, maybe? Yeah. Well, I have no, like... I have no idea what it could be, so.
What will it be? Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
God, it looks so fat. Well, the only thing I can think of, thanks to chat, is horse.
I want to see that answer.
I don't think it will be up there, though, but. Never mind. That shut me the fuck up.
Exactly. All right, family number one. You got the points.
I can't believe we stole all those points. I cannot believe that. Bro.
Takes us to the end of this round. Let's check the scoreboard.
That's hilarious.
Family number one, you are off to a great start.
Because we got one right answer. We stole everything. Family Feud's balance is fucked.
Let's go. It's time for round two.
God, this FMV.
I need a couple more players.
Alright, bring in Not My Dad.
We surveyed 100 people. Top 5 answers are up on the board. Try to guess the most popular answer. You ready to do this? Name a kind of place that you go to that has a gift shop.
Museum?
Family number one.
No, I'm spelling that right. Incorrect, I mean. Museum? I think that's how you spell it.
All right. Show me that answer.
Yeah, I didn't think so. Sad part of the guys answering the poll were
number one. You get a chance.
Crab and chicken's answers. They'd be part of the question. Yeah.
What do you think it is, family number two?
Hospital? Yeah, hospitals have gift shops.
Let's see if it's up there. Hospital.
Right. What? It is America.
Our top answer. Way to go. We need a decision.
Gotta drain money from people. Somehow, you know, just in case, you know, the prices for their fucking healthcare weren't ridiculously high. Who has fucking gift shops in hospitals? An art gallery?
Quickly. All right. Show me that answer.
Never mind.
Strike one, sorry. Next player, let's go.
God, I'm just trying to remember what kind of things would have a gift shop that I've seen on, like, American TV. Like a national park, maybe? Going as fast as I can.
Is it there? Let's see.
Oh, a zoo maybe. Yeah, that would work.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm still baffled that fucking hospital is the top answer.
Next family. One more strike and you're up. Another player. We need another answer. Name a kind of place that you go to that has a gift shop. I want to see that answer.
Okay. What are the fucking answers in, like, year 2000s America? I want to know. Because this is fucking crazy.
What will it be? Next player, let's go.
Like, yeah, amusement park will most likely be up there. Like, I didn't realize that until, you know, yeah, you put it in. But, like, what else could it be? I wouldn't call a
show.
I swear to God. What kind of shopping center has a gift?
You did it, family number two. Well done.
What else? Is it going to show us, like, the other answers? Like,
what
the... Yeah, okay. What else we got? What stupid shit we got?
What was in third place?
A hotel or resort.
And to complete the board...
An airport. I spelt museum wrong.
Families are doing after round two.
I fucking spelt museum wrong.
Family number two, you're not far off the lead.
God fucking damn it. I'm so mad. I am so fucking mad.
Okay, it's round three. Let's go.
Actually mad.
I need two more players up here. Let's go. We surveyed 100 people. You know, it's always 100 people, never 90. Top six answers are up on the board. Try to give the most popular one. Both families ready? Name something secretaries turn on when they get to work.
Their boss.
Okay, family number one.
I'm a computer.
Let's see if it's on the board.
Stop all the downloading.
Right on.
Good answer. But there's a couple that can beat it. So let's see what our next family says. Your answer, family number two.
Desk lamp. Radio. Right, I gotta think this is... This is the year 2000. So, old shit I gotta think of.
Cool.
But they still use fax machines back then.
We need a decision. Play or pass. Family number one is going to play. Next player, let's go. Name something secretaries turn on when they get to work.
No, actually, yeah, just facts in general work. Something tells me. If I type in fax machine, alright.
It's not up there. Strike number one. Next player, let's go.
Now, this is going to be pretty dumb. I don't think this is going to be on there, but remember that they're surveying, like, average Americans. They probably don't know how fucking phones work.
Good guess, but it's not there. I gotta give you another strike. Next family, one more strike, and you're up. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
Nah, I'm just gonna go with light, because I can't think of anything else. When they get to work.
Is it there? Show us!
Alright, lights are up there. So I miss out an S there, but that counts. But, like, I add an extra letter to museum, and that doesn't count.
Another player, okay.
Okay.
Got an answer for us? Name something secretaries turn on when they get to work.
Love
that
lamp.
Is already on the board.
Oh, that does. Okay, apparently that. Okay. That counts as light. Shit. Ceiling fan, maybe? I'll just put on fan. I legit can't think of anything else.
Alright. Show me that answer.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top six. Next family.
What will it be?
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name something secretaries turn on.
Alright, what do you got? Ah, air conditioner, yeah.
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says.
Oh, air conditioner wasn't it. I still get the points. Alright, good.
No, it's not up there.
I swear, if fax machine is on there,
gets the points.
I'm gonna be mad.
What was our most popular answer? Let's see what was the second most popular answer.
Typewriters require electricity? Oh, coffee maker. Yeah, that makes sense.
That takes us to the end of this round. Let's check the scoreboard.
Since when were typewriters, like, electrically powered? That seems very inefficient.
Both families are playing well.
Vax is called a copier. No, it's a photo. No, it's a photocopier. It's a different thing.
In round four, points are tripled, but you only get one strike. And then the other family gets a chance to steal. Let's play. Two more players and we can get going. Let's do it. We surveyed 100 people. Top five answers are up on the board. Here we go. Ready? Name an emotion that people sometimes have trouble communicating to others.
Easy. Love.
What do you
That's gonna be like the top one, right?
Okay. see that answer.
Man, this is a great question for someone like me who is autistic.
Love.
I have trouble expressing all emotions to people.
Our top answer. Way to go. Play or pass?
Disappointment.
Family number one is going to play. Next family member, what do you say? Name an emotion that people sometimes have trouble communicating to others.
The anger.
Okay, show me the answer.
Yeah. Only seven, all right.
Good answer, good answer. Another player, you need another answer. Name an emotion that people sometimes have trouble communicating to others.
Nope, no. There we go.
All right, show me that answer.
Yep, sadness and depression. Yep, that one hits home.
Exactly. Next player, what's your guess?
Yeah, I can think of like joy or happiness. And other than that, no idea. Actually, yeah, go with joy, not happiness first. Though something tells me I should have gone with happiness, though. Alright, they better not grab one. They better not get an answer.
Yes, but no, gotta give you a strike. A chance to steal coming up. Okay, next family. Next family member, what do you say?
Don't you dare. If it's happiness, I'm gonna be mad.
People sometimes have trouble communicating to others.
Fear, right.
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says.
Fear could probably be up there, yeah. Shit, we lose.
Absolutely.
We were doing so well, too.
Yes, family number two, you get the point.
If the other one is happiness, I swear to God.
And to finish the board.
Sympathy, okay.
That takes us to the end of
I wouldn't
round.
Have gotten that one.
Let's check the scoreboard.
I wouldn't have fucking got that one for the life of me. Yeah, I get it. I lose.
Good game, everybody. Going to the fast money round is our big winner. Family number two. See you next time on Family Feud. Goodbye, everybody.
All right, see you, Louie. God, does I have to do this, like, every time? Like, after every match? Wow.
Hi, welcome to the family. Backstage, you need to pick a family.
Good old PS1 loading. The crazy athletic guys win. Yeah, beat the... God, what did I call us? It was something in grungy.
Our first family hails from Vancouver, British Columbia, and they describe themselves as baffling.
That's right, and baffling and grungy.
Let's hear it for them. Family number one. Smart. And sociable is how they describe themselves. They join us
Woo!
From Connecticut.
Yo, is this Ric Flair's family?
Hand, Family number two. These two families will be playing for big money on the Family Feud. And now, here's the host of Family Feud, Louie Anderson.
This FMV, man, is so bad.
I've got the questions, you've got the answers, let's have some fun. We surveyed 100 people, top 4 answers are on the board. Try to give the most popular answer. Both families, ready? Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
God, crumbs.
What do you think it is, family number one? Let's see if it's up there.
Hey, there we go.
Yes, indeed.
Good answer, but there's one that can beat it. Next family.
What beats it, though? Body odor?
What do you think it is, family number two?
Would you call that a trail? Empty boxes.
Is it there? Show us!
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Oh, well.
No, it's not up there. Play or pass?
No, I'm gonna pass this one.
Right, family number two is gonna play.
Other than crumbs, I legit have like no idea what other answers could be. Let's see if the AI can get it. If they can, they deserve it. Fuck it.
Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
Dirty clothes, yeah, that works.
Is it there? Show us!
If anything, it'd be more of a pile. Than a trail. Alright, never mind. Fuck me.
Right on.
You got it. Our number one answer. Another player. We need another answer. Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
Like, yeah, they'd be gross and dirty, but not literal
I hope
dirt.
It's up there for you. That's strike number one. Next player, let's go. Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
Unfinished projects. Yeah, sure, dude.
Good answer. Good answer! Is it up there?
See, I feel like the only answer I could come up with in this situation
but sorry.
That would probably be up there. It's probably stench.
Family number one, one more strike and you're up. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
Garbage. The trash man.
Let's see if it's up there.
All right, garbage.
Exactly. Next family member, what do you say? Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
Rappers. Well, that's technically garbage already.
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says.
Yeah, alright.
No.
Good guess. But it's not there.
So yeah, my only guess is stench.
What will it be? Next
but it's one of those things like, will it accept stench or smell?
Tell me something slobs leave a trail of.
How do you spell stench? I just realized. I don't think that's how you spell it. Crap.
Better hurry up. Hurry, we're running out of time. Is it there?
I think I spelt it wrong. Crap. Alright, what's the other answer?
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top four. Family number two, you did it! Excellent! And to wrap things up...
dishes.
That takes us to
a trail of dishes, okay.
Let's check the scoreboard.
Never heard it being referred to as a trail of dishes before.
You're playing well, family number two. Keep it up.
Oh, that's what I get for thinking the AI wouldn't do a good job.
Remember for each family. Let's go. We surveyed 100 people. Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Everybody ready?
All right, what next?
Name a place where you are watched by TV security cameras.
The bank.
Your answer, family number one. All right, show me that answer.
All right. Now, what are the other three?
Our top answer. Way to go.
Ooh, a mole, yeah. Play or
you're playing? Okay.
So, yeah. Honestly, I'm just thinking of, like, places that you go to in fucking Payday 2.
Name a place where you are watched by TV security. I hope it's up there for you.
Would it be shopping mall?
It's not up there. Strike number one.
Jewelry store, yeah, good point.
Next
that
player,
could work.
What's your guess? Name a place where you are watched by TV security cameras. Quickly.
Yeah, I'm coming.
I want to see that answer.
It probably means, like, oh, jewelry store works. Yeah, it probably means, like, it's probably looking for a shopping mall specifically, not just mall.
Next player, what's your guess?
But yeah, supermarket as well, that would probably work.
Name a place where you are watched by TV security cameras. I hope it's up there for you.
Grocery store or convenience store?
Exactly.
Okay, I'm going to try shopping mall specifically. If that doesn't work, then I have no fucking clue. Oh, police station, actually, yeah.
Name a place where you are watched by TV security.
I'll try shopping mall first.
Is it there? That Let's see.
All right, so it's not that.
Good answer, but sorry. Your second strike. Next family, one more strike, and you're up. Next player, what's your guess? Name a place where you are watched by TV security cameras.
Okay, police station isn't there, then it's probably prison. Alright. Jeez. Don't have much of a clue for the last one after police station or jail, yeah. Come on, you fuckers better not get it.
What will it be? Next player.
Better not get it.
Name a place where you are watched by TV security cameras.
Dept? You it's in a department store? I swear to fuck.
Good answer! Good answer!
We had the right ideas, but it wasn't the very specific way they wanted me to say it.
That brings us to the end of the second round.
See, I love playing these games because, like, they're legitimately fun to do on stream, but it's situations like this that makes me fucking hate them. Because sometimes you have to be so incredibly specific.
Okay, it's round three. Let's go.
Like, that's why I picked a mall and shopping mall, because I didn't know which would technically count.
Come on, another player from each family. You know the drill. 100 people did the survey. Top 8 answers are up on the board. Good luck.
All right, what do we got?
You ready to do this? Name an occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brain.
Streaming.
What do you think it is, family number one?
Now this is a stereotype, but you actually need a lot of know-how to be a plumber, surprisingly.
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says.
Alright. Never mind.
I'm sorry, but it's not one of our top answers. Let's let family number two try.
Garbage man.
Okay, family number two.
Stock market? You'd be surprised.
Okay.
It's like, yeah, we joke, but need to know a lot about the stock market. Really? Construction?
Absolutely. Play or pass? What do you want to do? Family number two is going to play.
All right, the AI's playing.
Another player.
My second guess is garbage man.
Name an occupation in which you can.
And that's really all I got.
A lot of brain.
Technically, yeah, since that's more of like a physical job than a a mentally taxing one.
Pro athlete. Good answer, number one. Next player, what's your guess? Name an occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of...
There it is. Yep, garbage collector.
You never know what's going to be up there.
Cashier could be one, yeah. Yep, garbage man.
Absolutely.
Takes one to know one.
Next player,
eat that, Shelbyville.
occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains.
Truck driver.
I want to see that answer.
Driving my truck with my high heels on.
Right on.
Good answer. Good answer. Next family member, what do you say?
Ooh, Janita, yeah.
In which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains.
I resent that statement.
I want to see that answer.
All right, fuck you, America.
Exactly. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
Take offense to that.
Name an occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains.
See, that's just a jerk. You need to be stupid smart for politics.
Is it up there?
Yeah.
Woo-hoo.
Say stream if this wasn't PS1. Hey, I said that right at the beginning as a joke.
Another player. You need another answer.
Like, I'm fucking dumb as bricks. I'm still getting money for this shit.
A lot of money without a lot of brains. Good answer! Good answer! Is it up there?
Didn't think so.
Jeez.
Good answer, but sorry. Your first strike.
Oh.
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Name an occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains.
Gambler. Yeah, that counts.
Good answer. Good answer. Is it up there?
People consider that a job. If they're a professional gambler, but okay,
uh-oh.
It's not on there.
That's strike number two. Family number one. One more strike and you're up. Next player. Let's go. Name an occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains.
Model, yeah. As derogatory as it is, yeah.
Survey says.
Yeah.
Ooh, bouncer and bodyguard. Yeah, that would be pretty good, yeah. But you gotta think. Would the average American think of that answer?
Occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains. Is it there? Let's see.
Good. I was about to fucking
yes, but no.
Take offense to that too. Soldier then. Ooh, maybe.
Okay, next family. Next player. Let's go.
I'm taking a risk. I'm going soldier.
Name an occupation in which you can make a lot of money without a lot of brains.
I believe this is how you spell it.
Survey says.
I always forget that there's an I in there somewhere. Alright, never mind. Well, I lose.
Good answer. But it wasn't in our top eight. You did it, family number two. Well done.
I'm gonna win one of these games eventually. Alright, what's the answer? A salesperson.
Let's check out how both families are doing after this round.
That's way too generic. That's way too generic of an answer.
Remember, families, it's anybody's game. The last round will decide it.
What do you mean? What? Don't you need 200 points and then you go off to the thing? Isn't that how Family Feud works? Excuse me?
Round 4 points are tripled, but you only get one strike. Then the other family gets a chance to steal. Let's play.
Well, I need to do stupid good at this round.
I need a couple more players. We surveyed 100 people. Top 5 answers are up on the board. Try to guess the most popular answer. Are you ready? Name something that new mothers have to lug around with them.
The baby.
Your answer, family number 1. I want to see that answer.
How's that only 3? It's the main thing.
A couple that can beat it.
It's the main thing new mothers lug around with them is the baby. Excuse me, what? Oh yeah, baby formula if you're a bad parent.
Is it there? Show us.
Oh, okay, we keep going.
Exactly. Player pack.
Gonna play.
Family number 1 is going to play.
I only have 1 answer, though, and it's diapers. Oh, how convenient that the new mother of the family is doing this, is doing this answer.
Alright, show me that answer.
How is baby and diapers not number 1? Oh, God.
Next family member, what do you say?
Enlarged breasts?
To lug around with them everywhere they go. I want to see that answer.
All right.
Good guess, but no.
Do they just not have those, like, pumps back in the 2000s? Well.
Okay, next family. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
My only other answer I could have given is, like, pacifiers.
Name something that new mothers have to lug around with them everywhere they
diaper
go.
Bag. I swear.
I want
to. I swear if diapers and diaper bag are separate answers.
Diaper bag.
Woohoo! I hate this fucking game. I hate this fucking game. I swear to Christ.
Family number 2, you get the points. And to complete the board.
Stroller. Yeah.
That takes us to the end of this round. Let's.
I didn't get a single fucking point. Fuck Family Feud.
Good game, everybody. Going to the fast money round is our big winner.
That wasn't GG. That was BG, in fact. That was, in fact, BG. I can't believe I lost to Ric Flair's family. That's bullshit.
See you next time.
Jane would agree with you in a recent video. She also played Family Feud. She did, didn't she? Right, right.
Hi, welcome to the Family Feud.
I forgot that. When did that video come out? Like last week?
You need to pick a family.
But yeah, like, it's stupid shit like that is why I love these games. It's because they're so fucking frustrating. It's like, you know the answers, but it's gotta be, like, formatted in a way that the game actually recognizes.
Baffling and grungy is how they describe themselves. They join us.
Also, like, imagine playing this if you're not from America as well. Like a good example would be like that previous question. We don't call them diapers here. We call them nappies. So we would have been fucked if you didn't think like an American. They're too regional as well, these kinds of games. So you specifically have to think like an American, and most people only know about America from like pop culture and shit.
It's time for the feud. I've got the questions, you've got the answers. Let's have some fun.
Yeah, another regional thing, going back on that last question. We don't call them strollers either, they're called prams.
50 people surveyed twice, that's 100 people. We got top 4 answers. You just gotta give them to us. Ready? Name something besides yourself that you walk.
A car.
Okay, family number one. I want to see that answer.
Because what else would it be?
Yeah! You got it! Our number one answer! What will it be? Family number one.
Okay, so I'm thinking clothes, kitchen. If kitchen doesn't work, then house.
Next player, what's your guess?
Cannot think of anything else though. Oh yeah, pet.
Name something beside yourself that you wash.
I just thought I probably should have put in laundry, not clothes. Okay, clothes works. Okay.
Yes, indeed.
Exactly. Another player. You need another answer. Name something beside yourself.
Okay, let's go with pets.
Okay. Show me the answer.
Ooh, dishes. Yeah, dishes. Yeah. Okay, not pets.
It's not up there. Strike number one. Next player, what's your guess? Name something beside yourself that you wash. Let's see if it's up there.
Ooh, windows too, yeah. Hey, there's dishes.
Yeah! Absolutely.
Now, just that fucking last one.
Next player,
what would that be?
Name something beside yourself that you wash.
I'm gonna go with window, because I can't think of anything else.
You never know what's gonna be up there.
So teeth? I'd say most people would think of... Hey, windows works, okay. Cool. I was gonna say most people would think they brush their teeth, not wash their teeth.
Give family number one.
Technically the same thing, but you know, it's language. But hey, apparently Windows was it.
Let's check out how both families are doing after the first round.
There you go. Way better start than last time.
Well done, family number one. Let's go. It's time for round two. I need two more players up here. Let's go.
Next question.
People, top four answers are on the board. Try to give the most popular answer. Everybody ready? Name something that's white and expensive.
I got nothing.
Family number two.
What, are diamonds technically white?
Good answer. Good answer. Is it up there?
It's translucent, if anything.
I'm sorry. Over to family number one.
Necklace? I'm gonna... Because I have literally nothing. Like a pearl necklace, maybe.
Is it there? Let's see.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
No, it's not up there. Let's try this again, and we'll put up another survey on the board.
Good. Not gonna tell us the answers to any of those? All right.
100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers up on the board. We're looking for the most popular answer. Good luck. Are you ready? Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature. Name another such sport. It is family number one.
Oh god, I had one, then I immediately lost it. Rock climbing? I meant to hit space. Right. I hit done. Oh, I'm an idiot. I'm big dumb.
Oh well.
I'm sorry, but it's not one of our top answers. Let's let family number two try. Family number two.
Mountain climbing. That's technically the same fucking thing.
All right. Let's see if it's on the board.
Of course it's number one. Son of a bitch. If I wasn't stupid.
Good answer. Number one. We need a decision. Play or pass. Family number two is going to play.
All right, good, because I have literally, like, hunting, technically, because people consider that a sport.
Another player.
But, like, other than that, no fucking clue.
Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature. Name another
sport. Oh, surfing, yeah.
Survey says...
God, I should get my dad in here. He'd be great at this.
Woohoo! Exactly. That's clear. Let's go. Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature. Name another.
Bullfighting. Right.
You never know what's going to be up there. Survey says...
Sorry, Matador, but apparently what you do doesn't count as a sport. Won't be needing those buffs today.
Next player, let's go.
That's a Shin Megami Tensei reference, ladies and gentlemen.
Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature. Name another such sport.
Skiing, technically, yeah.
Good answer. Is it up there?
Only very technically. Alright, yeah, skiing.
Yeah! Absolutely.
Scuba diving even a sport? I don't think that counts.
That's family member. What do you say?
I don't think that's considered a sport. That's more of a hobby.
Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature. Name another.
Lion wrestling? This isn't fucking Rome. What are you talking about?
Let's see if it's up there.
I'm gonna laugh so hard if... Was gonna say, I was gonna laugh so hard if lion wrestling was up there.
Strike number two. Family number one. One more strike, and you get a chance to steal. Next family member, what do you say? Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature.
Ooh, skydiving, yeah.
I hope it's up there for you.
That is, for some reason, considered a sport. That was the second answer that was nine.
Good
only
answer.
Worth 9 points.
Good answer. Another player, okay. Got an answer for us? Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature.
Hydroplane racing? Man, that's an incredibly American fucking answer.
Up there. Okay, next family. Another player. We need another answer.
Would swimming technically count?
Shooting the rapids is one sport that pits man against nature. Name another such sport. Is it there? Let's see.
All right, my other choice was hunting, so...
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top six.
YouTuber boxing isn't
right,
about elements, Damo.
What was in third place?
That, and this is a game from 2000.
Let's see what was in fourth.
Hang gliding. Oh, yeah, good point. I knew hunting was one of them. I should have just stuck with it. Every time. Every fucking time. I should have just stuck with hunting. Like, at the last second, I'm like, swimming makes sense. Should have just stuck with my guns. Ha ha! That's a fucking joke. I'm hilarious.
I need two more players up here. Let's go. You know the drill. 100 people did the survey. Top six answers up on the board. Good luck.
All right, what's the next question?
Ready? Everyone likes a day off from work. Name something else you'd like a day off from. Sorry, time's up.
That's just, all right, I hit the button. And we'll put never mind, I was going to say parenting.
One 100 people surveyed. We've got the top six answers. You just gotta guess them. Good luck. Everybody ready? Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the morning?
I got nothing.
Family number two.
Kids, good point. See, that's what I don't think of because I'm not a parent.
There for you.
Yeah, I was gonna say pets.
Yes, indeed.
Very good. But there's two up there that can beat it. Next family gets a chance.
You just wanted an excuse to write cock in my chat, didn't you?
Okay, family number one. Is it there? Let's see.
Bruh.
Oh well.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our
Do Americans just not have pets?
What are you gonna do? Play or pass? Gonna play? Let's go.
Oh, time to let the AI do all the work.
Another player, okay.
It saw the opportunity and took it.
Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the morning? Survey says...
Yeah. All right, shower.
Absolutely. That's clear. Let's go.
Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the morning?
People good still answer. Listen to the radio good in the answer. 2000s?
Up there.
It was literally 2000, so yeah, probably. Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Well, if radio is up there, TV will probably be there, too.
Next family member, what do you say? Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the morning?
Turlet.
Okay. Show me the answer.
Spent six long years on that turlet.
Yeah.
It's not up there. Strike number one. Oh. Next family member, what do you say?
Japanese toilet.
Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the morning?
Back in the 2000s, people wouldn't have known the majesty
good
of Japanese
good
toilets.
Answer. Is it up there?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. Strike number two. Family number one. One more strike and you're up. Next player. What's your guess?
Is it a dog and a cat as separate answers? I swear to God. If it is, I'm gonna be mad.
First thing around your home to start making.
Don't steal my answer, you prick! I've got nothing else.
Survey says
it's gonna be number one, isn't it? Oh, okay, never mind.
Yes indeed.
Good answer! Good answer. Next player, what's your guess? Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the morning?
Fuck off.
Okay.
Game, don't do this to me. Don't fucking do this to me.
Yeah. Exactly. That's clear. Let's go.
I am so fucking mad.
Besides your alarm clock, what's the first thing around your home to start making noise in the
morning? And that was going to be, like, my last answer. If that's number... Yeah, that's probably going to be number one. Yep.
Coffee maker?
Yes, indeed.
That is so fucking frustrating.
Our top answer. Way to go.
See, what have I been saying? You can give them the right answer, but if you don't format it in the specific way that they want... I said pets, they wanted animals.
Let's check the scoreboard.
Bullshit.
What a close game. Both families are playing well. In round four, points are tripled, but you only get one strike. And then the other family gets a chance to steal. Let's play.
Gonna vent my frustrations with this, because when the fuck am I ever going to use this button?
Hello, ¿cómo estás, coño?
I need a couple
What's
more
up,
players.
Coño? Hi, my name is Iron Mouse, coño, coñito, coño, coñito, coño, coñito, coño,
we surveyed 100 people. You know, it's always 100 people, never 90. Top six answers are up on the board. Try to give the most popular one.
All right, gotta win this one. What's the question?
Ready? Name something from home that people take on long trips.
I was gonna say your phone, then I realized 2000. Shit. Fuck it. I think mobile phones were still, you know, difficult to carry around and shit. Yeah.
I'm sorry, but it's not one of our top answers.
Crap.
Let's let family number two try.
See, you gotta think. Like, you gotta remember, this was made in 2000, so... Bring an alarm clock with you?
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says...
Bruh.
Exactly. Player pack. Family number two is going to play.
Of course they are. Who the fuck brings an alarm clock? Fucking crazy people,
another
apparently.
Player. We need another answer.
That's the first thing I tried.
Name something from home that people take on long trips. Survey says.
All right.
It's not up there. I gotta give you a strike. Next family, you can steal.
I gotta get the top answer. I can only think of board games.
What will it be? Another player. We need another answer.
Literally all I can think of is board games.
Take on long trip. All right. Let's see if it's on the board.
God damn it.
What was the number one response? What was in second?
A pillow. Right. That makes
what
sense.
What was in third place? What was the fourth most popular answer? What was in the fifth spot?
Yeah, I feel dumb for not thinking of any of this. Yeah, I feel real dumb.
To the end of this round. Let's check the scoreboard.
We started off so well, and then just threw it all away.
Nice work, everyone. Moving on to the fast money round is our top money winner. Family number two. Thanks for playing the Family Feud. See you again next time. Remember, be good to your family.
Son of a bitch.
Hi, welcome to the backstage.
All right, another game. I'm gonna win one eventually. Sure could have used more point hunting instead. Shut up. Shut the fuck up.
They're from Vancouver, British Columbia, and they describe themselves as baffling, but mostly grungy. Give it up for family number one.
Just realized I missed out on fun clips. Oh no!
Topeka, and they describe themselves
not the
as
clips.
Being strong and hip. Let's hear it for them. Family number two.
And I'm looking through my, like, soundboard over here, and I'm like, I'm looking through all these old buttons that I haven't used in God knows how long. I have one that's just a picture of JonTron. I have no idea what this does. Hold on.
Holy shit, you fucking killer, dude!
Alright, yeah, that'd do it.
People survey. We've got their top five answers up there. Good luck. You ready to do this? Name something besides food or drink that you can buy from a vending machine.
I have answers, but no one in 2000s America would know that.
Family number two?
I was going to say underwear, which is a Japanese thing.
Oh, well.
Yes, I do have that button.
Guess,
where the fuck is it?
Let's give
is
family
it?
Number one a shot.
Where is it?
Okay, family number one.
I've seen some places that have fruit in them.
Survey says.
Where the fuck is it? Ah, there it is.
Life is pain! I hate-
Yep.
Oh, well.
No, it's not up there.
Well, starting this one off strong, huh?
We'll put up another survey on the board. We surveyed 100 people. Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Both families ready? In the old days, how were castles protected?
With moats and knights.
Family number one.
Trebuchets.
Let's see if it's on the board.
Ballistas. Cannons.
Number two answer. Only one's gonna beat it. Next family.
If the number one is moat, I'm gonna be mad.
Family number two.
I don't think, like, high walls. I was gonna say, like, I don't think
Let's see
the average one. American in the 2000s would know what the fuck a moat is.
We need a decision.
I'm a play.
Number one is going to play. Next player, what's your guess? In the old days, how were castles protected?
With a moat.
You never know what's going to be up there. Survey says.
Didn't think so.
Oh, well.
Good answer, but no. Gotta give you a strike. Oh. Next player, what's your guess? In the old days, how were castles protected?
Archers. There we go. Autocomplete. There we go.
That is already on the board.
Oh, that must count as... Okay. Drawbridge?
Quickly. Hurry, we're running out of time. Let's see if it's up there.
Oh, I spelt moat wrong. Okay. I spelt it as the other moat.
Another player, okay. Got an answer for us?
Alright, I'll spell it correctly this time.
Is it there? Show us!
There we go. Thank you.
Moat. All right. Good answer. Number one. Give family number one those points.
So yeah, I spelt it as in moat, as in like an item, not, you know, the moat that we know. Imagine missing out on this one, yeah.
Family number one, you're playing great.
Don't want a repeat of Museum like we did at the beginning of the stream.
It's time for round two. I need two more players up here. Let's go. A 100 people surveyed. We've got their top 5 answers up there. Good luck. You ready to do this? Who was the last person you lied to?
I don't fucking know.
Okay, family
it's
number two.
Very personal. Sweetheart,
good
really?
Answer. Good answer.
Not partner? Fucking. I got really stumped on that one, because that's. Because that's more of a personal question, more than it's like, hey, what do you think people do with this?
Your answer, family number one. All right, show me that answer.
All right, mother is there.
Good answer! Good answer! We need a decision. You gonna play? All right!
Okay, I can think of... Yeah, we did mother, sweetheart is there. Father, child, co-worker. Or, if not co-worker, boss.
Who was the last person you lied to?
Watch them both be separate answers.
Let's see if it's up there.
Mother's up there, but not father. Okay.
Sorry, not on the board. That's strike one.
Yeah, kids too, during those Discovery player, Channel moments in private. Yeah.
Who was the last person you lied to?
Now, here's the thing. Would it be kids or child or children?
Show me that answer.
All right.
Oh, well.
If that doesn't work, then yeah, I'm going to go for boss.
Strike. One more strike and you're up, family number two. Next player, let's go. Who was the last person you lied to? Okay, show me the answer.
Boss is number two.
Right on.
Exactly.
Who else would it be then if father isn't up there?
Next player, let's go.
Ooh, friend, yeah, maybe.
Who was the last person you lied to?
N-D.
Okay, show me the answer.
What's number one?
Absolutely.
What would number one be?
Next player, what's your guess?
If it's not father and it's not...
Who was the last person you lied to?
The only thing I could think of is... Yeah. I was gonna go children, but okay. What about kids, specifically?
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says...
If it's children...
Good answer, but
I swear to fuck... I swear to God, if it's children.
Okay, next family. Next family member, what do you say?
Better not be children. Yeah, considering that I already used it.
I didn't think of that because Sweetheart was already up there. I thought technically that would be the same fucking thing.
You got it! Our number one answer! Alright, family number two. You get the points this round. Brings us to the end of round two. Let's look at the scores.
Still, who calls their fucking, you know, like their partner, their sweetheart? In, like, a thing like this.
You're within striking distance now, family number two. Okay, it's round three. Let's go. Come on, another player from each family. A 100 people surveyed. We've got their top 5 answers up there. Good luck. Ready? Name something that you see at every tourist attraction. All out of time.
Yeah, I got nothing. Even the AI had nothing.
Another survey. A 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers are on the board. We're looking for the most popular answer. Good luck. Are you ready? Name a sport a lot of people bet on.
Football.
What do you think it is, family number one?
Horse racing would be my second. It's probably the, yeah, like, the, as I was, like, about to hit, you know, enter, my next thing would be, like, oh, right, horse racing.
Number two answer, only one's gonna beat it. Next family.
Don't you dare.
What do you think it is, family number two?
Tennis? People bet on tennis?
Okay, show me the answer.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Good answer, but it wasn't in our top 4. We need a decision.
Alright, horse racing, right. Baseball, basketball is what I'm thinking.
Another player. We need another answer. Name a sport a lot of people bet on.
Horse racing. Now autocomplete.
You never know what's gonna be up there. Survey says.
There it is.
Horse races. All right. You got it. Our number one answer. Next player. Let's go. Name a sport a lot of people bet on.
No, not babbling. Baseball.
Is it there? Show us!
No, not baseball? Alright.
Sorry, not on the board. That's strike one. Another player. We need another answer. Name a sport a lot of people bet on.
And then basketball.
I want to see that answer.
Oh.
I have no clue what they could be. My only other guess is, as stupid as it is wrestling.
One more strike and you're up, family number two. Next player, let's go. Name a sport a lot of people bet on.
It's as dumb as it is, since it's, you know, like a scripted thing, people still bet on it. I know people do.
Yeah.
I can't believe it's not there. Sorry.
Alright, what the fuck were the other answers?
Next family, it's your turn.
I swear to God, you better not get it.
Got an answer for us? Name a sport a lot of people bet on.
Auto racing.
Is it there?
Rugby? They don't have rugby in America. If anything, like, rugby is American football.
Oh, well.
Alright. We at least got the points. What the fuck were the answers, though? It's gonna be some, like, bullshit cop-out. Some cop-out fucking answers.
Was in third. And to wrap things up.
Oh yeah, people bet on boxing. Dog races are the same as horse racing. Fuck off. Forgot that was a thing. I forgot people bet on boxing matches.
What a close game. Both families are playing well. In round four, points are tripled, but you only get one strike. Then the other family gets a chance to steal. Let's play.
All right. Last one. Here's hoping I don't fuck this up.
Two more players and we can get going.
This really is like the round that decides everything, because triple points is absurd. It should be double, if anything.
100 people surveyed. We've got the top three answers. You just got to guess them.
God, only three.
You ready to do this? Name something people pluck.
Eyebrows.
What do you think it is, family number one?
Ooh, thank you. Autocomplete.
Okay. Show me the answer.
Hey.
Eyebrows, hair.
Right off the bat.
Yes, indeed.
Our top answer. Way to go. What are you going to do? Play or pass?
I'm going to play.
Family number one is going to play.
Yeah, because I can think of feathers.
What's your guess?
I can't think of anything else, though.
Name something people pluck. I want to see that answer. Yeah.
What would the other one be,
good
though?
Good answer! Good answer.
What is something people pluck?
Another player. You need another answer.
Hair can be plucked too. Yeah, eyebrows, hair is the same thing.
Name something people pluck.
Shit. This is gonna be out there, but like, strings?
That answer.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Jeez.
All right.
Oh, strike one.
Come on, AI, don't get this. Please, I swear to God, do not get this.
What will it be? Another player. We need another answer. Name something people pluck.
Sweaters? Pluck sweaters? Okay, that...
You never know what's going to be
that
there.
Can't be it. Right? Right, chat? Yeah, that's what I thought. Hey, we finally win one!
Good guess, but no. Family number one, you did it. Way to go.
What's the last answer, though? Hey, look, a win, Kappa. Yeah, finally, right?
That takes us to the end of this round.
I said strings as in, like... Guitar strings, of course. I technically got all three. Let's face it, that's what I meant.
Going to the fast money round is our big winner.
But I didn't think. I didn't think if I put guitar, like it would be, like the right answer. I thought they would want like more specific answer, like strings.
And we'll get going.
Probably should have written guitar strings specifically. That may have gotten it. Oh. Sure.
Five questions. Good luck. The clock starts when I finish reading the first question. Name a specific occupation at a circus. Name a member of a wedding party.
Be wife, wouldn't it?
Name something you make with ice cream.
How do I spell Sunday?
Tell me how long a teenager can stand in front of one video game machine.
Hours.
Name a sea creature you see washed up on the beach. Let's see how you did. Name a specific occupation at a circus.
Like that video game one is so weird. Oh, really? No ringleader? All right, clown it is then.
Name a member of a wedding party.
Wow, doing well. Doing well, chat.
With ice cream.
There we go, thank you.
Tell me how long a teenager can stand in front of one video game machine.
Yeah, I didn't expect that one to work. Is that one's kind of a weird question for this format.
We have a
member of a wedding, the priest. It's a wedding party.
If you don't know it, pass, and I'll get back to it if there's time.
Which honestly, I have no idea what a wedding party is. Not gonna lie.
Name a specific occupation at a circus. Name a member of a wedding party.
Bridesmaid.
Name something you make with ice cream.
What other things do I make with ice cream? No fucking clue.
Tell me how long a teenager can stand in front of one video game machine.
This is so fucking stupid.
Name a sea creature you see washed up on the beach.
Seal.
Name something you make with ice cream.
When you're the wingman at your brother's wedding? No, actually. What other things other than Sundays? I have no clue. I have no clue. Keep going. Yep, no clue.
Let's see how you did. Name a specific occupation at a circus.
There we go, that's better. Oh, a banana split. Yeah, good point.
Name something you make with ice cream. Tell me how long a teenager can stand in front of one video game machine.
Like, it doesn't give me numbers to work with, so that
creature you see washed up on the beach.
That doesn't seem right. How is whale only six? They're famous for being washed up on the beach.
Sorry.
What the fuck?
You're still our winning family, though. Congratulations.
Well, I still technically won. I still technically won the game. Just didn't win the extra thing.
See you next time on The Family Feud.
Sharks can wash up? Good point, yeah. Ah, well. Boop, 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 boop.
Hi, welcome to The Family Feud.
Shut up.
You can go directly back.
Shut up, you. Oh, well, with that, we've been playing Family Feud for 2 fucking hours. I think that's enough. We got one win, technically. That's enough for me. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me for a fucking Family Feud. That was fun, but also really fucking annoying. It really was. Oh, God. Anyway. Before I get to next week's schedule, I do have a bit of a PSA. At the end of tonight, today is actually the last day of daylight savings here in Australia. So for the next 6 months, all streams will start an hour early. So yeah, heads up for that. Big heads up for that. So yeah, I only found that out like a couple hours ago. So. Thank God people told me. Anyway, next week, next stream, like usual, Sunday is my day off, so the next stream will be on the Monday morning over at Switchaboo Live. We will be finishing off, Henchman Story. We will be finishing that off, so, yeah, reminder, starts an hour early. But, yeah, the next stream over here is... The surprise hit, like, not only, like, to me, I didn't expect to enjoy it, but I did, but, like, it's also actually weirdly doing well over on the YouTube archive, but, fucking House Flipper. Yeah, we're continuing House Flipper, next week, so, yeah, that's, it's got its claws in me. Son of a bitch. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me, and I hope to see you guys on Monday for, I always want to call it something else, but no, Henchman Story over at Switchaboo Live, and for those of you who don't watch that, I will catch you for House Flipper over here on Tuesday. Ciao.